Guaranteed a warm reception from the locals here in Amsterdam. We've had some fun tonight already, and I think they're going to have a little bit more now. Big Vincent van der Voort is on his way, and John McDonald is going to bring them out.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. A very warm welcome back to the first round action of the Jacks World Series of Darts Finals, coming to you live from Amsterdam! So brought to you by the Professional Darts Corporation. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for our live audience and the millions of viewers joining us around the world, it's time to meet the players. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Nathan Aspinall and the Dutch Destroyer, Vincent van der Voort.
And it is the World Grand Prix champion, Johnny Clayton, who'll be watching on with a lot of interest to see who he meets in round two tomorrow night. And so too, will John and Alan.
Thank you, Jackie. Well, I can tell you one thing for certain, whatever the outcome of this one, this match will not take very long. Nathan Aspinall doesn't hang about. Vincent van der Voort, as we all know, one of the quickest players in world darts. Nathan Aspinall, the younger man by 15 years, just 30 years old, but Vincent seems to have been around forever. Nathan Aspinall, quarter-finalist in 2020, and performed very well in our last big televised tournament on ITV, the European Championships, when he got to the semi-final and figured in that wonderful game against Michael van Gerwen. The Asp, now ranked number 9 in the world. Vincent van der Voort, whose career has been plagued by back injuries, back problems. The Dutch Destroyer, 45 years old now, and still maintaining a place in the top 32 in the world. Current PDC ranking, number 30.
First line, Vincent to throw first.
Vincent with the darts.
Game on.
Rated as a little bit of an upset if he were to win this, but you can hear the crowd are right behind him.
78.
Nathan Aspinall producing ton plus averages in the European Championship and starting quite brilliantly in this particular match, the opening 180. Could be a few of those.
125.
Well, there's a sad start there, John. Nathan Aspinall, in my view, is playing the darts of his career, and it's only a matter of time if he can carry on with that same standard that he's actually going to win another
96.
TV event. He's playing that well. And the fact that he knows he's playing well as well.
He's got that little bit of aggression back into his game, which is always a sure sign that he's playing well.
We spoke about that, didn't we, at the European Championships, and he almost fell over the line in one of the matches, and then his aggression came back, and we saw what he did in that. Well, those two matches against Noppert and Michael van Gerwen was just terrific darts, it really was.
The van Gerwen game was superb because MVG had smashed him in the early stages to go 7-1 up. And he hadn't played particularly well, but then he came right back, got it to 9-all, and eventually MVG just managing to edge him out, winning the match ultimately 11-10. Great game.
Yes, we had some terrific matches 29. In that tournament, certainly in that Vincent afternoon session. Chance for Vincent here though, very popular player, not just here, but all over the world. Oh, well, he got the cheers from the crowd, but it's not the target he needed.
109.
And that's no ball.
56.
56 required, tops now for 1-0 for a break of throw. Should be a good marker.
16.
But no.
Vincent, you require 16.
Big chance here now for Vincent. And there's no doubt whatsoever, we've seen it already, he's going to have the crowd behind him. It can sometimes work in your favour.
8.
maybe a little bit of tension there from 40. Vincent. There was certainly a little bit of tension at tops in the last visit from Nathan.
And gets there in the end. 18 darter. And in it goes.
Second leg, Nathan to throw first.
There's a very impressive array of fancy dress in the crowd this evening.
You can imagine
They've made an effort, haven't they?
They certainly have. You can imagine 44. Them really waiting. They love the darts in Holland, we know. They'll have been waiting for this tournament for quite some time, no doubt. And they're certainly 100. Making their voices heard. And there's some, as you can see, a lot going on behind them.
And you know who the favourite is as the song goes up again for Vincent.
Here he goes.
140.
The noise in that auditorium is incredible. I think George has dropped his wallet. I wonder what that noise was.
That would be a resounding thud. Nathan Aspinall's concentration, you suspect, and a chance for Vincent to get a break back here.
Yes, Nathan's got to be careful. He eventually got that first leg, but he doesn't want Vincent to get into the match, because then he'll be not just playing Vincent van der Voort, but everybody in the auditorium.
Beat him in the World Championships in the third round this year.
105.
4-1. Say this year, it was actually last year, I suppose, wasn't it? But it was this year's World Championship, if you see what I mean. Beat him 4-2 in the third round.
170.
Eventually going out to Daryl Gurney in the fourth.
Well, I would have seen this in the last match from Jeffrey Desvan. Not on this occasion.
134.
I always remember Nathan getting that 170 check out to win the UK Open in 2019. Double 16.
74. Nathan, you require 36.
Keep his composure.
He was on the second leg, Nathan Aspinall. Third leg, Vincent.
I was going to say he's quiet in the crowd, but I don't think I can say that. Perhaps he's going mental in there.
There's a fair few, I think, who are concerned with other things than just darts.
Well, they're certainly enjoying themselves. That's what we want to see. Party atmosphere and world-class darts.
I'll tell you what, Walter, we'll raise the roof when Michael Van Gerwen plays tomorrow.
Yes, that'll be pretty special.
140.
Vincent needs to get a foothold in this match.
Yes, he's got a good chance here.
125.
One of the players in real special form at this moment in his career. Such a long time ago since Vincent 85. UK Open Final 2007, 14 years ago. Never really...
Was that Barney, that final?
I think it was Barney, yes. He's never really moved on, has he, from there?
A
very popular player, but there and thereabouts, but just can't quite get to the later stages on a regular basis. So got so much ability, as we're seeing here. Leaves himself tops.
That's a great setup.
Now, 136.
Great dart.
Oh, this would hurt.
96.
A double ooh,
Vincent, there.
Tops then for Vincent van der Voort to take his first leg of the match.
And
just one dart required.
Well, that will settle him, no doubt, John. I mean, he really needed to get his first leg on the board, get the crowd involved, the volume getting louder.
134.
As the song goes up again.
Just a little bit of pause for the last one. Lost his
55
grip on the dart.
It's one of the biggest. He's one of the biggest men on the circuit, isn't he, Vincent? He must be about 6. What is he? 6'4", 6'5", thereabouts.
Yes, he is one of the tallest.
Bigger than you are.
100.
I'm 6'3 and he's a bit, probably about 6'5, I'll do.
I'm
being told by our experts behind the scenes that Vincent van der Voort's official height is 6'6".
As he gets a maximum,
but not yet on a finish.
65.
Well, 65's not a gimme, so Vincent's got a follow that up, which he is doing. 14 would leave double 16, or maybe 6
for tops. 26.
So 65, Nathan Aspinall for a hold of throw. He's under pressure here though. That's a great first dart. Double 10 now. This is a pressure moment. Vincent can only watch and hope, and he's got to have his chance of a break back.
Vincent Uruguay,
well, said not too long ago that Vincent's got his first leg on the board. He doesn't want Vincent coming back at him because he'll be fighting the whole auditorium as well as his opponent.
Amsterdam believes the Dutchman back on level terms, and don't they love it?
They're absolutely loving it.
Game on.
And he's now got the throw, looking hopefully a lead going into the first break.
Needed that travel with the last dart there. Likewise, conversely, how Nathan would like to nick this one and have the break advantage at the interval. Vincent coming back with a 13 darter and a 14 darter to square up the match.
Yeah, that's quality.
There's the averages, they're not bad either. High 90s.
25.
Very high 90s now for Vincent.
Well, he's performing pretty well, but I think most importantly, he got himself back into the match. He missed a few darts at doubling that first leg. Went 2-0 down, and some players can crumble a little bit, can't they, under that pressure.
93.
Of being behind against a top quality opponent. The crowd singing along there, desperate to get you back 60. In the match. But he is experienced, Vincent van der Voort.
He's got every opportunity of taking this leg though and having his nose in front. At the break. 90 required when he comes back. Nathan would have really liked to have filled up that treble 20.
100.
Well, realistically, needed another one there, didn't he, for a decent finish. So chance for Vincent here for 3-2.
Double 5.
80. Maybe you go 158.
He didn't waste time there, did he? 158. No, sir.
Well, he's not been finding that 96. Trouble 20 with the first dart with the regularity that he has been recently.
So this is double 5 for the leg. And van der Voort gets it. Breathes a bit of a sigh of relief. The Dutch fans are very happy. A little bit of a celebration from Vincent, but he's still got some work to do. Leaves the stage, leading 3-2. So it's advantage to the Dutchman. If it all went with throw, he'd be the man into the next round to face Johnny Clayton.
Yes, looking good for Vincent now. 2-0 down, he's done well to really grab himself a lifeline and get himself back into the match and then lead at that first break, 3-2.
Game on.
The Orange Army are in full cry behind their man. Aspinall has all the work to do.
Well, he was a big favourite to win this one, the Asp. But as you've said on more than one occasion, Vincent will be inspired by the support he's getting. And I tell you what, if he gets close to winning this, they really will be right behind him. It'll be mighty tough for the Stockport man.
Well, Nathan needs that purple 96. Patch that he's so capable of. We've seen it so often, certainly recently. I said earlier, he's playing some of the best darts he's of his career, but this is a really big challenge now.
100
against Vincent, who's not just playing well, but has all the crowd on his side as well.
He's got to find a break, otherwise Vincent will be the winner.
59.
They're loving it in there, aren't they? Absolutely loving it.
140.
Very youthful crowd, isn't it? You usually see, I think in UK crowds, you see a much greater generational mix, but there's not too many oldies out there.
134.
You're looking at me when you said that.
Me, surely not.
Oh, wrong side.
86.
So, Nathan Aspinall might have to get this one to prevent the break. 16 would leave bullseye. Oh, he's missed it.
Oh, he's gone for the treble.
And that's the danger.
There it is.
59.
When things are going in your favour, they go in.
Great chance for Van der Voort. Tops. Double 10. And that's a big dart. That's the break he was craving.
Certainly was, John, and it's really piled the pressure on Nathan Aspinall because it was against the throw.
Not happening for him, is it? He's shaking his head, a little bit mystified. He's probably been in the practice room 60. Hitting huge numbers for fun and getting up there on the stage. But at the moment, it's not quite there.
Well, he got into that 2-0 lead and he wasn't really playing his best darts. So you almost expected that to happen at some point in the match. Well, it's going to happen pretty soon.
He's being outscored by Van der Voort. And the stat which matters most of all now is that he has that two-leg cushion, Big Vincent.
Yeah, talk about it all the time, that race to six. It's strange six when we look back historically where we used to play best of five in lots of tournaments. But now the minimum is, you know, the race to six.
50.
Play in all the players' championships, the Pro Tours, the European Tours, a lot of first round of the TV events.
60.
It can be a little bit brutal. It is an unforgiving format. You can't be finding your form very easily up there on stage. And if you come out flying, then you're well on your way. Great darts. Leaves him on a finish. 63 required.
Oh, it's been a great night for the Dutch players so far.
Vincent, you're going 63.
Treble 13, maybe. 10 would leave tops.
Plenty of time.
43.
Bit of a dip.
Describes it better than any words, doesn't it?
That was perfect. Thank you, Vincent. One of the Dutch masters, Vincent.
Vision, you require 20.
In more ways than one.
Double 10 then. Double 5, big dart. And he's taken it. That was a huge dart for the match.
It certainly was, John, because if he'd have missed that, Nathan would have had the opportunity
85.
To get back in the match. But now, one leg away for the Amsterdam Arena to erupt.
100.
There will be some noise if he manages to finish it in this leg.
81.
Got a chance here to get ahead.
The bottom line, John, is he's played better. I know that's easy to say when somebody's 5-2 ahead, but all the stats are in his favour. He's taken out the crucial doubles at crucial times, and Nathan just hasn't been. And we said at the start, he's playing some of the darts of his career. Sometimes you get up there and it just doesn't happen.
Body language sort of tells a tale, doesn't it? And he's just not been able to find that form, that sort of form that we saw in Salzburg at the European Championships.
Yes, when your opponent gets to one leg away from winning,
59.
You know, there's anything you can do about it.
Aspinall
needs a big hit here. And he's finding it. What a time to do that.
Yes, apart from giving him a great opportunity to take the leg, just maybe get a little bit of momentum, but he's going to be pressurised by Vincent.
Great last dart. Sneaks it in the top corner. So, 70 for 5-3. Double eight. Nicely done. Aspinall, all the 17 darter, but most importantly, hold the throw. Now, is this going to be the moment for the big Dutchman?
Yeah, show some quality there from Nathan to hold it all together, 55. To stay in the match. Now he's got to start playing some of his best darts we mentioned earlier. If he can take this one, 100. All of a sudden the pressure will swing very quickly to the Dutchman.
Hold the throw and Van der Voort goes through 81. Into tomorrow's second round, where the winner will play Johnny Clayton, and it looks as though it's going to be Vincent van der Voort.
57.
That's not what the doctor ordered.
No, he's just not finding that treble 20 with the first dart. A lot of players want not just hitting the treble 20, 90. But the angle where the dart lands, so you can follow up with dart 2 and 3.
More like it.
Well, giving himself a chance. It's all down to really what Vincent can hit in the next two visits. Can't leave a finish now.
Well, this is a great opportunity now for Nathan Aspinall to bite back. He'll be the first one onto a finish.
And he'll be aware of that as well, John. 96. He knows the position he's in. He's been on the back foot for most of the match. He did lead 2-0. Since then, it's been all about Vincent van der Voort.
That was off a treble wire.
74.
Good last dart.
Nathan,
so, to keep the match alive, 108. Treble 19 would leave double 16.
Treble 18.
56.
Well, no big trouble there, but he's still on the 2-darter. Oh, is he going to stay there? Oh, can't blame him.
94.
When you've got,
the line started.
Well, yeah, you can't blame people for doing that.
Double 16 for the break of throw. Composes himself. And with that 36. Dart, his chance might have gone.
Yes, he fought so hard, didn't he, to get that opportunity, but he's missed it.
Crowd, Vincent van der Voort, the Dutch hero, is through and he loves it. And why not? There'll be plenty of singing in celebration of Vincent van der Voort through to play Johnny Clayton tomorrow and winning by 6-3.
I think those Dutch supporters quite enjoyed themselves tonight, didn't they? Really got behind Vincent right from the start, and they knew they were in for some entertainment, bearing in mind the way he plays. He's always great fun to watch. Nathan going out, though, at the first hurdle. Those are the stats. 6-3 the score, 93 average compared to 91 for Nathan. 5 180s between them, and Vincent 38% on the doubles, and we will see him back there tomorrow in Amsterdam up against Johnny Clayton. So it's only Dimitri Vandenberg who's left wondering who he's going to meet tomorrow night, because José de Souza